Hello, anatomy friends. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to Station 9. And we are finishing our discussion of the joints that are associated with the head region with the TMJ. So you have that TMJ. That is where it's getting its name. So in terms of its bony parts, we are going to have that mandibular condyle of the mandible articulating with the mandibular fossa, which is going to be inferior here, but it's about in that level where the dash blue line is. And you can see when we're looking at with the other structures that are associated with this region, this right here is going to be your masseter muscle. It's one of your largest mastication muscles that is going to be on the anterior side of the ramus of the mandible. And just posterior to it, you can see a bit of this zygomatic arch right here. And this complex right here is going to be part of the temporomandibular joint. So what you're seeing right here in this region, and you can see it as well here with the masseter muscle reflected, is you're looking at ligaments associated with the joint as well as the actual articular capsule here. So you can't see the bony parts because it's being covered by the articular capsule. But if that is removed, and it has to be done very carefully because it's pretty adhered to this region, you can see the mandibular condyle is right here. This has been cut in order to be able to see some of the neurovasculature associated with the mandible. There's that inferior alveolar nerve that we talked about in another video. The mandibular fossa would be right in this region. And then within what would have been the capsule, within that cavity region, this is the articular disc. And if you recall our discussion in the lecture videos, that articular disc serves to subdivide the articular cavity into two different spaces to allow two different types of movements to occur. So that is that articular disc right there in the middle. All right, so being able to identify the TMJ and where it is located in a few different views, from the osteological to the basic location of where it would be with other structures, and then a very deep dissection able to see that articular disc. Thank you for your time and attention here, and as always, please reach out if you have any questions.